Hey, God bless you. God bless you. Welcome to Retro once again. What a wonderful season for us to express our love for Jesus. Oh, Christmas time is very special. And today, we're going to present a dynamic word for you. You're going to be transformed. You're going to be changed. God is going to do a great thing in your life today. We have Pastor James ministering the power of Thanksgiving. Need power? Stay tuned, because we're going to give you the magnificent word of God, and you're going to feel the presence right there in your room. But before Pastor James preaches, we have Shabbat. Shabbat is going to be ministering. We love Shabbat. Enjoy them, and we'll be back.
Everybody say, Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are.
You see, to some of us, that's just a catchy tune. But to many of us, that's our way of life. Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper. Sometimes you get overwhelmed by the situations that you go through. And in no way can anyone in this world help us in the dilemmas that we are in right now. We are in serious trouble. As far as the world sees us, we're in serious trouble. Our country and our world needs Jesus.
Hallelujah.
And you are the conveyor belt of Jesus. There's no other way that peace is going to come. Peace, peace, wonderful peace. Is that what you need? Well, that's what the world needs. Now you are contagious with the peace of God. You must bring the peace to those that are worn out. People are tired. We can't trust anybody out there. Things are getting turned over. Finding out all of the corruption in our Congress. It's coming to the surface. But isn't that what Jesus said? In the end times, it's all going to be exposed. Why do we think it's strange? He told us, beware. When that happens, it's not happening by accident. I've had it up to here with sin. And you have the answer. We have the answer. We are going to be just about ending our 30 days this 30th, which I think is what, Wednesday or Thursday, right? We complete 30 days. And I want to tell you, church, things are stirring in the body. Things are happening in the body.
Hallelujah.
And when it's happening, you cannot take it for granted. You hear me? Oh, yes, God, thank God. I got an answer to prayer. And you're back down and you forget your 15 minutes the next day. Yeah. Come on, we're all sons of Adam.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
We're all flesh.
Yeah.
We know we're not perfected. We're learning. 30 days we have gone into the courts of the Lord, interceding. And I want to tell you, things are really looking up. Things are looking good here. God is going to use this church to touch many, many, many lives. I thank all the folks this Thanksgiving weekend who tune in online and on Facebook. Week after week, you're the silent audience. I wish you were a little bit more vocal. Let us know that you're out there. But what an honor to come into your private place with the light of the gospel. Where there's darkness, where there's depression, we bring the light of the gospel. We bring this worship, which we feel the inhabitation of the Lord. I think we've got the best worship team. They're so filled with the power of God, filled with the anointing of the Lord. We thank God for them because they usher in the presence of God. Once He's here, we work smart and not hard. We receive His glory and His presence. I want to read something to you. My Jesus Calling book is all taped, and you know, it just feeds me. During this Thanksgiving season, it says, a thankful attitude opens windows of heaven. Spiritual blessings fall freely unto you through those openings in eternity. Moreover, as you look up with a grateful heart, you get a glimpse of glory. Through those windows, you cannot yet live in heaven, but you can experience and foretaste it as your ultimate home. Such samples of heavenly fare revive your hope. Thankfulness opens you up to experience, which then provides further reasons to be grateful. Thankfulness is not some sort of magic formula. It is the language of love, which enables you to communicate intimately with me, says God. A thankful mindset does not entail denial of the reality in your life with its plethora of problems. Instead, it rejoices in me. I am your Savior. In the midst of your trial and tribulation, I am your refuge and strength, an ever-present and well-proved help in trouble. I trust that this Thanksgiving season, I really appreciate it. I know some people say, oh, I'm thankful every day. I don't need Thanksgiving. The world needs Thanksgiving. This nation needs to be alert and understand, okay, shape up. It's not about the turkey. It's the season. Everybody's giving thanks for something. It doesn't matter. We all need to be grateful.
Yes.
Give thanks with a grateful heart. You can say things back up to the Lord and receive the infilling of the hope that you need. How many this morning need a touch in your body? You need a healing in your body. From your head to your neck, to your shoulders, to your knees, to your feet. Let me see, raise your hand up. Hallelujah. Well, we're going to take advantage of the presence of God that's here right now. And we're going to pray. And Jesus, you know, in Isaiah 9, Isaiah announced him. He's coming. He will be born and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Jesus, say the name. Say it with your heart.
Jesus.
Say it one more time.
Jesus.
He is healer. He is healer. And he's right here. How silly of us not to take advantage. We've summoned his presence. Now what do we do with it? We take advantage of it. Amen? You need that touch from the Lord. I believe. I got up this morning. The Holy Spirit said, I want to heal somebody this morning. And I know, my dear precious, where is your auntie or your Diane, where is she? Come, Mama. We're going to pray for you. She goes back to Texas. I said, today is your healing day. You see, expectancy brings the faith. Amen? Come on, anybody else needing healing? Step right up. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Kerabasototebaraba. Didabasondo tebiarabaka. Kibana sato toboshete. The doctor is in. Kalama soto tomoshete. Ilama torbesta shebaka. In the name of Jesus. I want you all to extend your hands in this direction.
I believe you're more than.
This household. Let there be a divine visitation coming into this home. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus.
Yes, you are.
Healing to a house.
Nothing, nothing.
Father, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus.
You hold.
In the name of Jesus.
You hold.
Be now made whole. Hold. In the name of Jesus.
Nothing.
Father, in the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
In Jesus' name.
Hallelujah.
Believe he's able.
Yes. Amen.
Do we believe God is able?
Yes.
Do we believe God is able?
Yes.
Right now, I need you to just extend your faith to this precious sister. What does she suffer from? Arthritis. In the name of Jesus Christ, who we serve, we know he is able.
Yes.
Precious sister, to touch your body, you go back home whole.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus, it wasn't just turkey you came here for. It was to touch the hem of his garment.
Yes. Yes.
We thank you, Lord God, that you have good plans for my sister.
Yes. Thank you.
Doesn't matter how old we are, God, the plan still works.
Yes.
God, I pray you give us strength in the marrow of her bones.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus,
yes.
Let her dance. Like her nieces
yes.
do, dancing
yes.
before the Lord.
Yes.
In
yes.
Jesus'
yes.
name, giving you the glory,
yes.
the honor,
you,
and the
Jesus.
Praise. in Jesus' name.
Oh, yes, thank you,
in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Are you ready to dance? Come on now. She's ready.
The scripture shows us time and time again that Jesus gave thanks. The Bible says he took bread, broke it, gave thanks. No, if Jesus gave thanks, what does that say about us? David gave thanks, and many of the other Bible believers, they made it common practice to give thanks. Why was it so important for them to give thanks? Well, I believe that giving thanks, it allows us to understand first and foremost that there's a greater power involved in what we're doing. Understand that now first, because we said what the definition was, to acknowledgement of. So we're giving thanks to a greater power. So when we give thanks, first and foremost, we're saying, God, I understand that I'm not in this thing by myself. So I'm going to acknowledge that you are the creator and the maker of all things. So I'm giving thanks. And as I give thanks, it begins to shift my mindset. I believe that giving thanks opens up our minds, opens up the portals of heavens to allow us to receive from God. Have you ever noticed that when you are complaining and you're not thankful for anything, it seems your mindset is all bogged down. But when you begin to just give thanks for the little things, God, I thank you for waking me up this morning. God, I thank you for how you closed me in my right mind. God, I thank you for that you put food on my table. God, I thank you that you have my family here and they're healthy. God, I thank you for everything you're doing for me. It causes us to have a shift in our mindset, which allows us to be able to receive even more of what God would have for us to receive. But when you're in that mindset that you just can't be thankful for anything and you're always complaining, you begin to shut off the blessings from heaven. So I want you to understand today, even if you have not been in a place that you've been given thanks, I want you to shift your mindset and just start giving thanks for even the small things. 1 Thessalonians 5:18 tells us that in everything, give thanks. For this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning, it isn't saying just the good things. Can you give thanks when you don't have the money to pay your light bill? Can you give thanks when your kid is in the hospital about to have surgery? Can you give thanks when your mother has lost her mind and it seems like she just doesn't have the right mind? Can you give thanks in the bad times? The word scripture says, in everything, give thanks. Why? Because when we begin to give thanks, it begins to shift the atmosphere. It begins to change how you think. And you find yourself going from a place of depression to a place of joy. So you've got to shift your mindset even as you go through, because God wants to change the way you perceive the situation. Give thanks. In everything, give thanks. And then Philippians 4:6 tells us, be anxious for nothing, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your request be made known unto God. So you're praying and you're seeking God's face. But as you're asking him, it says what? Prayer and supplication with thanks. Are you giving thanks as you're asking? God, my body needs healing, but I'm giving you thanks. God, I got pain racking all through my body, but you know what? I'm giving you thanks because I know that you're the healer. God, I don't know how I'm going to make it through this situation, but guess what? I'm going to give you thanks because you're always with me. So when we give thanks, we acknowledge that there's a greater power that's connected to us, and this power has all power in his hand. When we give thanks, we're tapping into our source, the creator of the universe. When we give thanks, we're letting God know that we know that he's right there with us and that he's got our back. give thanks. I want you to stand to your feet. In this season, I want us to, in this season, in this year, strong. Amen. So we're trying to get you into the mindset that even though this is the holiday season, and some people don't understand that for the holiday season, it's not all joy and happiness for everybody. There are a lot of people that struggle during this time of season. And if you're one of those people that struggle through the holiday season, even if you're one of those people that don't struggle, I want you to just begin to get into your mind the importance of giving thanks. Stand to your feet. Give thanks. Giving thanks. I want you to listen. I'm going to have everybody in this place come up to this altar, because we're going to shift our mindsets. We're going to be at a place that if you have not been one to give thanks, from this moment forward, you're going to start giving thanks even for the small things. Is that all right? So I want you to come up to the altar. I want everybody under the sound of my voice to come up to this altar right now. Come on up here. Come on up. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Let me hear you say it.
Thank you, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank.
Yes, God.
I just want. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
I just want to take a little time right now and thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me.
I just want to take a little time right now and thank you, Lord. For all you've done.
Come on, say it again. I just want to take a little time right now
and thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me. I just want to take a little time right now and thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Listen. We want you to just forget about what happened yesterday. And, you know, if you've been one that has not been very thankful for all that God has done for you, well, yesterday is gone. We're going to finish this year strong. Amen. And we're going to finish it giving God thanks. So we're standing here today because I'm putting you on the spot. I want you to put you on the spot so that you can remember that every day of your life when you get up, you're going to give God thanks for something. Amen. Even if it's just, Father, I thank you for waking me up this morning. Is that okay with y'all? I want you to just begin to just make it your business that no matter what it is, God, each and every day, I'm going to be thankful for what you've done, God. For the small things, for the big things. I'm going to be thankful for it all, God, because I know me giving thanks in my go-through, it shifts my mindset and it allows me to receive even more from you, God. Bow your heads. Father, in the name of Jesus, God, we thank you today. Your word declares, in everything give thanks, for this is the will of Christ Jesus concerning me. So, Father, we are standing here before God and man, saying that from this moment forward, we're going to give thanks, God. And just like when pastor asked about those that had a blessing or that those had, that had something to say, we're going to make it our business, God, that even if it's nothing major that's happened, we're going to say thank you for life, health, and strength, God. We're going to say thank you for the right mind you've given us, God. We're going to say thank you for our family, God. We're going to say thank you for giving us a job, God. God, we thank you for being such an awesome God. We love you, Jesus. And we're going to give you thanks from this day forward. In Jesus' name. Now put your hands together and tell the Lord thank you. Hallelujah.
We truly have felt the Holy Spirit in His presence today. I trust you've enjoyed Pastor James' message, the power of thanksgiving. Don't get caught up with all the Christmas stuff that you forget to give thanks for the blessings that He's given you. We have so much going on here at the church. Don't celebrate alone. Come and visit us on Fowler Street. Every weekend we have something special. You can go online and check us out at fmcoc.com. Check our calendar. Come and be a part. We're family. We're family. You need to talk to somebody. Sometimes the holiday brings in a little bit of the blues, a little bit of depression, oppression. Call us. We'll lift that right off. We're a Holy Ghost church. We believe in the power of deliverance. Give us a call. Just love coming into your home. I trust every week it changes your life. That's why we're here. I pray that you have a wonderful, wonderful Christmas season. As I said, come and see us whenever you can. Hey, the Lord bless you. Bless you, empower you with all that you need. In Jesus' name, see you.